As migrants continue to enter the U.S. from Mexico, the number of unaccompanied children in the custody of the Department of Health and Human Services is now over 18,000. The Catholic organization Hope Border Institute is working to help them and others. Their executive director, Dylan Corbett, joins us now. So, Dylan, talk about how desperate these migrants must be to leave their children to come to the U.S., then have smugglers bring them to the border and abandon them there. I keep thinking of that video of those two little girls who were dropped over the 14-foot fence.
Yeah, I think you're right. Desperation is the correct word. There's been a series of events in Central America in recent months that is causing a northward flow of people coming from Central America and also from Mexico to our U.S.-Mexico border. We're talking about things like hurricanes. There were a couple of devastating hurricanes towards the end of the year last year that really devastated parts of Central America, especially countries like Honduras. And then, you know, there's also the effects of the pandemic. We all know in the United States how difficult it's been on our local communities, but communities south of the border have even less means to be resilient in the face of the pressures of the pandemic, which are unemployment, which are lack of vaccines, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. The governments in those countries aren't able to help their populations as much. So it's really a toxic combination of things. It's the pandemic, it's unemployment, it's the hurricanes, the devastation from that. It's political insecurity, mm-hmm. It's violence. There are so many things that are affecting those countries right now, just a toxic cocktail. And that's forcing families to make the hard decision to come north or children to cross the border.
So tell us what you're seeing at the border every day and what Hope Border Institute does to help the kids and the families that cross.
Sure. So we're seeing that arrival. We're here in El Paso, Texas. We're in West Texas, but we're on the U.S.-Mexico border. And we share a border with our sister city in Mexico, Ciudad Juarez. So there's a growing population of migrants in Ciudad Juarez. There are folks who are coming north, and then there are also folks who are being returned by the U.S. government to Ciudad Juarez. Many people think that right now the Biden administration has more lax policies at the border, but the reality is that the Biden administration is returning the vast majority of people who come to the border, including families, including moms and dads and children, back to places like Ciudad Juarez. So we're seeing that population grow. And these are folks who need everything. They're homeless, so they need a place to stay. They need food. They need to start thinking about what their next move is. So there's a whole range of things, human needs that they need. And it's really been churches that have been stepping into the gap and faith communities providing that level of support.
I was going to ask you that. What are churches and faith leaders doing specifically to help out?
Yeah, the Catholic Church has long been a leader in providing support to migrants here in the United States, in Mexico, and in Central America. So there's an entire network of migrant shelters that provides support to families as they make their way north to the border. And here at the border, it's really the faith community that has led in making sure that we're providing for just the basic services and needs that families need. Like I said, shelter, food, opportunities to work sometimes if we can facilitate connections so that people can take care of their family, basic medical services. One of the things that we're doing right now is because some migrants have been spending many months and years in places like Ciudad Juarez, they're open to new life and there are new families that are being born. And so mothers need maternal care, children need pediatric care. So medical services are important as well. And these are services that local governments, the government in Mexico, for example, is just not able to provide. And so it is churches that are stepping into the gap. And that's true across the whole border. Folks know about Sister Norma and the wonderful work she does in South mm-hmm. Texas. Here it's Bishop Seitz and the Catholic churches on both sides of the border. In Arizona border, it's the Jesuits. In California, it's Catholic Charities and other faith communities, too, like the Jewish faith community are stepping up. To recognize the human dignity of migrants and make sure that families are provided for.
All right, Dylan Corbett, Executive Director of Hope Border Institute. Thanks for being with us today, and thanks for the work that you do at the border.
Thank you.
If you're watching Currents News on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click on the bell to get updates to all of our newest content, because we are putting your faith in the news.